I'd like to say thank you for being here tonight. I'm excited about the Browders being with us. Now, Tommy is the daddy of this bunch right here. Tommy, I've come to the conclusion that Matthew is a professional bugger. That's all he knows how to do. Bug you. He bugs you. He called me, Brother Belch, we want to come sing for you. Brother Belch, we want to come sing for you. Brother Belch, we want to come sing for you. Finally, I said, Matthew, when you ever get close to Monroe County, you let me know and I'll come hear you first. Well, he called me. We're going to be in Cleveland. I said, I'll be there. So me and Helen drove down to Cleveland one Sunday morning. I said, we're going to go in, we're going to sit in the back row. If they ain't no count, we're getting up and leaving. Well, lo and behold, the church service already started. We walked in, and there was an usher standing there. He said, Brother Belcher. He said, got a couple seats right over here for you. I said, no, we'll go in the balcony. We're just, no, we got a couple seats right over here. I said, okay. So he brought us down. Guess where we were at? Front row. Right next to the assistant pastor. So I said, well, we're here, Alan. We're going to stay, I guess. But I tell you, when I first talked to the Browders, Helen said, who are they? And I said, you know, I don't know them very well, but boy, they have some good music out right now. Amen. They've got some songs that are really touching. And, matter of fact, I asked Matthew before the service. He was telling me about one of their CDs, and this is unheard of in gospel music. They had 7 number one songs on that CD. Ooh, wow. That's a lot for one CD. Anyway, I am so glad that y'all are here tonight to open up our revival for us. Ladies and gentlemen, would you make welcome the Browders.
Till my eyes overload the ones who have died. Yeah. joy it is to be at Bethlehem Baptist Church. What a beautiful facility. But more than that, I feel the presence of the Lord in this atmosphere. Would you give Jesus a hand clap of praise? It's a joy to be here and kick off revival. I believe you're going to have a great revival. We are the Browders from a little place called Hilton's, Virginia. How many is this the first time seeing our family in person? Let me see your hands. Wow. We come from Hilton's, Virginia. It's right over the hill from Kingsport, Tennessee. How many knows where Hilton's, Virginia is? We got some of them. You know, it's where you can burn your bathroom down without catching your house on fire. We from the sticks. Real quickly, I want to introduce the band to you back here on the guitars. Doing a terrific job. This is my brother-in-law, Mr. Burton Ludwig. Would you make him welcome? Back here on the drums, he is a newlywed, enjoying married life. I like that wave you got going on with your hair there, Derek. I tried to fix mine like that. Couldn't get it fixed. So left it on the bus. This is our drummer, Mr. Derek Kress from Kingsport, Tennessee. Over here to my right is my beautiful wife. July will be 13 years that we have been married. This is Miss Sonia Browder.
My husband writes most of the music that we do. Almost everything that you've heard us sing on the radio or that we'll do tonight is something that he's either written or co-written, and he's my favorite preacher in the world as well. You glad to see Matthew here tonight?
We got a new addition coming to the family very soon. Sonia's due August the 2nd. It's our first little baby girl, little Sadie Adeline Browder. So I am very excited. I can hardly wait for that girl to get here. Over here to my far left is my little brother. Doing a wonderful job on the bass and singing vocals, and his wife is with him tonight. Very supportive family. His boys are doing really good in school, Ethan and Elijah. They used to get to travel with us most of the time, and now they don't get to travel with us as much. They do during the summer months, and Kim is with him tonight, and I know he's happy to have his bride on the road with him this trip. This is my little brother, David Browder. Would you make him welcome? Over to my far left, this man is no stranger to gospel music. He's been in gospel music now for over 50 years, spreading the good news. And he didn't let a thing like polio stop him from doing something for God. This is my daddy. Would you make him welcome? Mr. Tommy Browder, right here. I want Dad to do his testimony song for a good friend, Paul Belcher, and all you fine folks here. I am so blessed. My faith has been tried through the furnace of life, but I wasn't alone. God was there all the time. He turned sleepless nights into sweet rest. I'll always be grateful, 'cause I am so blessed. God's given so much. He's more than enough. Yeah. Supplies all my needs from his storehouse of love. He brought me this far, but I must confess, the best is in.
Before his great big throne, I wanna bring my rewards. This old body redeemed, among heaven's guests.
Mr. Browder, we've done all we can do for your son. There's no way that he's going to live. But then there was a heavenly doctor. He walked into my bedside and he said, I've got a plan. And that plan, no doubt in my mind, was for me to be doing what I'm doing here this evening. It's giving God praise, worship. Polio left me with my right arm and hand completely paralyzed. It took a miracle for me to be able to play any instrument at all. But I met that God of miracles on my knees in a little storefront church in Kingsport, Tennessee. My dad was preaching that night. I still remember the message. Only 8 years old, he preached, "You must be born again." I felt the conviction power.
And I made my way in invitation down that aisle, knelt on my knees, gave my heart to Jesus. He saved me that night by his marvelous grace. That year he gave me my first song, 3 verses and a chorus. And I said, Lord, I'd love to be able to play music with those songs that you're giving me. That dream came true when some volunteer music teachers came to our handicapped school. One of those was a guitar teacher. My school teacher saw my interest in the guitar, and she bought me my first one. Shortly after that, my little mother of 8 children threatened to chop it up for kindling wood. I was tormenting her to death, trying to make a noise, but after much prayer and dedication, one day the thumb started working, then the fingers started working. And over 50 years now, I've been traveling the road for Jesus, giving him praise. I'm reminded of the scripture, Philippians 4:13. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. God's got a plan for each and every one of your lives. What are you going to do with it from this day forward?
serve a God that is alive and very much alive. Praise God. Of a dying flower, our Lord bowed down his head. Mary's heart sunk in sadness. She watched him take his last breath. He was planted in the garden inside a rich mansion. 3 days later, they discovered that the rose of Sharon. He's not dead, he is alive. God gave his promise on the third morning that he would rise. The angel goes the stone away. Jesus, so hot out of the grave, praise his name. Satan could not believe that the King of Kings had risen. Oh, but the proof was plain to see. Now the footprints of our Savior are on the devil's head. It is defeated forever, church. My Lord arose just like he said. Yeah. I'm glad that there's no problem too big for our God. The doctor to deliver bad news. Now you're so troubled, you feel you're gonna lose. But I know a healer that best known to man. You know what? His practice is perfect, so just put it in the God's hands. Put it in the God's hands. He knows what to do. He's never too busy to care for you.
Serve a God that cares and is ready and is waiting.
understand that each need will be handled when you put it into God's hands. Help us sing it.
Would you like to stand up and just rest a minute?